Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Davia Edina binti Adnan and I'm from class 4 Ibnu Sina.
Assalamualaikum. My name is Karina from class 4 Ibnu Hafiz. We will learn about nervous system. This system is divided into the central nervous system and the peripheral nervous system. The central nervous system includes the brain and the spinal cord. The peripheral nervous system consists of 12 pairs of cranial nerves and 31 pairs of spinal nerves. The cranial nerves send nerve impulses from and to the brain, meanwhile spinal nerves send nerve impulses from and to the spinal cord.
The brain is the cognition and control center. All our information will be through our brain to give instruction to our body's other part to do our activities such as movement, eating, drinking and etc. Okay, in the brain we have 5 components. The first component is cerebrum, then we have hypothalamus, cerebellum, medulla oblongata and pituitary gland. The first component is cerebrum. It is the largest part in the human brain. The function is to initiate and coordinate movement and regulates the pressure. Other areas of the cerebrum allow us to do speech, judgment, thinking and reasoning problem. All the information will be received by the cerebrum and from the receptor that is located in the cerebrum. Then the information will be analyzed, integrated and correlated to produce our sensory perception. Your response is determined and instructions are given to the effectors that will allow us to do our daily routine. Okay, then we go to the second component of the brain, that it is hypothalamus. The hypothalamus is involved in different daily activities such as eating and drinking. Other than that, the hypothalamus also control our body temperature and the process of memorizing and stress control. It also control the secretion of few types of pituitary gland hormones. What is the pituitary gland? It is the main gland in the endocrine system. You know, it is also located at the base of the hypothalamus. The function is the gland secretes hormone that control the secretion of hormone by and the endocrine system. Then we have cerebellum. The main function is to maintain body balance and coordination of muscle contraction for body movement. It is also responsible for a number of functions including motor skill, such as balance, coordination and posture. Last but not least, we have medulla oblongata, located at the interior of the cerebellum. It controls our involuntary actions such as heartbeat, breathing and foot location.
Spinal cord is placed within vertebral column and surrounded by cerebrospinal fluid that protects and supplies nutrients for the spinal cord. The spinal cord made up of two matter, which are white matter and gray matter. The gray matter comprises mainly of body cells and surrounded by the white matter. Meanwhile, the white matter consists of myelin coated axon that extends up and down the spinal cord. The spinal nerve extends through the spinal cord by two roots, which are dorsal roots and ventral roots. The function of spinal cord is to process a few types of sensory information and send responses through the motor neurons, control reflex action and connect the brain with the peripheral nervous system. Next, we move on to the detailed function of the spinal cord structure. First, we have dorsal root ganglion, which the sensory neurons cell bodies are clustered in this root ganglion. Next is dorsal roots. Dorsal roots contains the axon of the sensory neurons that sends nerve impulses from the sensory receptor to the spinal cord. Ventral roots contains motor neurons that sends nerve impulses from the spinal cord to the effector. And lastly, we have spinal nerves, which contains the sensory neurons and motor neurons.
The peripheral nervous system consists of the somatic nervous system and the autonomic nervous system. The somatic nervous system regulates all the control actions. Meanwhile, the autonomic nervous system controls involuntary actions such as heartbeat and contraction of blood vessels. The function of the peripheral nervous system is to connect sensory receptors and effectors to the central nervous system.